Hello everyone, welcome back again. This is Nimisha here from English Form. We'll be discussing about one of the most important question types in listening module today. This is one of the very important question types in all of PT as well. And the question type is summarize for context. Let's start with it. So these are all the 8 types of questions that you would be getting under your listening module. Listening module is divided into 2 sections, section 1 and section 2. About section 2, I have already talked about in the other videos. Please have a look regarding the time management for this. I'll be making more explained videos in the coming days regarding the time management separately, not the question types, just time management alone. So we'll be discussing more in detail about that in the coming videos. Today, we'll be discussing only about section 1 of listening, which is called summarize for context. So summarize for context is a task where you will be listening to an audio, which could take up to 1 to 2 minutes time. So while you're listening to the audio, you're allowed to take down notes. So as most of you know, when you go to the exam center, you're not allowed to carry anything of your own. You're not even allowed to take your phone inside the exam center, not even your book or pen. So they'll be providing you with a notepad and pen, which you can use to take down notes throughout the exam. So during summarize for context as well, as you're listening to a 2-minute or 1-minute audio, you won't be able to remember everything that you hear. So it is always better to take down notes on the notebook provided. So what you do here is when you listen to the audio, take down notes. And once the audio is over, you're supposed to type the summary of the audio on the inside the box given on the screen. So you'll be getting 2 to 3 of them, and you'll be getting 10 minutes for each task. I'll explain more in detail. So this is a sample screenshot of the question type. As you can see, the instruction here is, you will hear a short report, write a summary for a fellow student who was not present. You should write 50 to 70 words. You have 10 minutes to finish this task. Your response will be judged on the quality of your writing and how well your response represents the key points presented in the report. Okay, so guys, remember, I have seen this misunderstanding among students. They think that the word, the title of the item, summarize for context, would be given in the exam. In the exam, they don't use the names like summarize for context, write from dictation, repeat sentence. They simply give you this instruction on top. So you should know what kind of instruction you would be getting for each question type. Otherwise, you'll be getting completely confused during the test because they will not use the names that we use to teach you. Like they don't use the name summarize for context. They don't use the name read aloud or repeat sentence. They just give you the task and give you the instructions on what you're supposed to do. So make sure you're familiar with the instruction which is given for every question type, so that just when you look at the screen itself, you know what question what you're doing. And also the word limits and the time limits for all of them should be very clear before you go to the exam. So as you can see, the recording status bar will be a box on top, and you will be typing the answer in the box given at the bottom. As you can see, you still have cut, copy, paste options here as well, and the word count will be given at the bottom. Again, I'm telling you, just like the other questions, in PTE, the cut, copy, paste options given to you can be used only to copy and paste from your own answer, not from the questions. So you cannot copy from another page. You cannot copy from another question. Whatever you typed inside the box, you can reuse it again by using cut, copy, paste options. Word count will be given at the bottom. You don't have to worry about counting the number of words that you write. It'll be given on the screen. And the total time for each task also will be given on the screen on the top right corner. This is just a introduction to what you're supposed to do here. In this section, you will listen to a short lecture. You are then asked to write a summary of that lecture within 50 to 70 words for a fellow student who was not present at the lecture. Now, the number of items you get in here, you will be getting minimum 2 summaries or maximum 3 summaries. And for each summary, the computer would be giving you 10 minutes time. And remember, there is no rollover time here. That means, even if you finish your first summary a little bit early, let's say you got first summary and you finished it within 5 minutes time, the extra remaining five minutes that you have will not be added to the next question, which means there is no point in finishing early here. Utilize all the 10 minutes given to you, because you need to remember you're typing an answer which is evaluated for your listening and writing. So your grammar, your spelling, your vocabulary, all these factors are very crucial. So if you rush through it, finish it off and move to the next question immediately without proofreading, you could end up losing a lot of points for your spelling, grammar, and vocabulary, which is the reason why they're giving you entire 10 minutes to listen and type your answer. Audio could take up to 2 minutes time. The remaining time is for you to type your answer, also to proofread it, double check it. Make sure you do this. I would like to say this 1,000 times, guys, because I have seen even my students make this mistake. They feel so overconfident that they're well prepared. And when they go to the exam, they don't proofread their answers. If you do not proofread, you could still have careless spelling errors because you're typing. So you could type here and there and it could go wrong in terms of spelling. So make sure you reread every word that you type to check for careless spelling errors, grammatical mistakes, and all those kinds of things, which is the reason why it is better to utilize all the 10 minutes given to you. There is no point in finishing early. Even if you finish early, the extra time will not be carried over to the next question. The next summary, again, you're going to get 10 minutes. So you're not saving any time. Now, the scoring for this question is 10 points per question. And the scoring from out of 90 would be contributed to two modules, listening and as well as writing, because in this task, you have to listen to an audio and you're typing the answer. Typing means you're writing. So it is contributing around 13 points out of 90 for your listening, around 12 points out of 90 for your writing as well, which is the reason why it is extremely important. So altogether, it carries around 25 points out of 90 shared between listening and writing. And also you need to remember, some of you might be getting confused now. Why did I say 10 points per question? If you get 33 questions, you should be getting 30 points. This 30 points is not the score out of 90. This is just the scoring criteria. So it is multiplied with its percentage weightage to convert it to 90. So the converted score in 90 is 13 points out of 90 for listening and 12 points out of 90 for your writing. 10 points is the scoring criteria. Scoring criteria means your answer will be evaluated based on 5 factors: content, form, vocabulary, grammar, and spelling. This is the scoring criteria. So each of these factors would be getting 2 points, which is giving you a total of 10 points. All right. So the first factor is content. So what you do here is you're listening to an audio and you're taking down notes, and using the notes that you have taken, you will be typing the summary based on your understanding. Now, a few things you need to remember here, guys. You are typing to a computer. Your answer is evaluated by a computer. Computer is a machine, of course. And a machine is not capable of understanding the meaning of what you write because it's a machine, obviously. So the only way the computer can understand you have written about the audio itself is only by cross-checking if you have the words which was already mentioned in the audio. Because what does the computer have? The computer has the transcript of the audio in its memory, and then it gets your answer. So what it does is it'll be comparing your answer with the transcript of the audio, looking for matching words. That is the only way the computer can check if you have written about the audio itself, which means even if your answer is not similar in meaning to the audio, if it is meaningful according to the audio, it's perfect. Even if it's not, even if it is not in the same meaning as of the audio, if you have minimum 10 to 15 matching keywords from the audio. Keywords means, what do you mean by keywords? Keywords are important words that you hear in the audio. Important words means topic words, whichever word that you hear repeatedly in the audio. I'll do an example so you'll understand better later. Or names of people, names of places, names of things, dates, numbers, all these will come under keywords, which means words like of, the, a, and, articles, prepositions. These words are not keywords. Mostly nouns, numbers, and dates would be your keywords. And whichever word that you hear repeatedly in the audio would be your keywords. So what you're supposed to do here, even if you do not understand the entire meaning of the audio, you don't have to bother. Just take down minimum 10 to 15 matching words from the audio in your answer. Now, another point coming to that, many people have a misunderstanding, especially students who have already done other exams like IELTS. You think that you are supposed to use another word. You're supposed to use synonyms as much as possible. But here you need to remember, if you use a synonym instead of the main word mentioned in the audio, when the computer cross-checks your transcript with your answer with the transcript of the audio, it won't see the same word. In PT, same words are always better than using synonyms, especially in these question types. So you don't have to think of another word with the same meaning. As much as possible, use the same words from the audio itself. So try to note down around 10 to 15 keywords, which are names of people, names of things, dates, names of places, numbers. All these would be good keywords. So try to get around 10 to 15 of them. As long as these keywords are there in your answer, no matter what, even if it is meaningless, the computer will still give you 2 points out of 10 for your content part. Now, the second factor is form. Form is also your word count or your basic structure of your answer. Now, when you write your answer, there is a specific rule here. The computer will accept your answer only if it is within 50 to 70. And just for writing within 50 to 70, you get another 2 points for content. This is an easy score. Like, you can easily get this 2 points. Just make sure that you write within 50 to 70 words. Never go below 50, never go above 70. Nothing less than 50, nothing more than 70. If possible, try to get 60 plus, because 50 is like the minimum end. Try to get more than half. 60 plus would be a good word count, because less than 60 will be looks a little bit too short, right? And not 71 also. More is also very bad here. Some people think that if they write more, they'll get more points, which is a very bad idea. Do not write more than 70. Do not write less than 50. That's why they're giving you a specific rule here, only 50 to 70 words, not 71, not 49 within this. And vocabulary, you get 2 points only if you use academic vocabulary, academic words. Academic words means words that you usually see in textbooks or academic articles or journals. Do not use slang words. Like, you should not write wanna, gonna, well, literally. The way that you talk or the way that you text should not be written in your answer here, because you need to remember PT is an academic exam. Use only formal words. Do not use slang words or even short forms. Do not write ETC, E.G. These are all affecting your vocabulary score. So instead of writing E.G, write example, E-X-A-M-P-L-E in full words. Do not use short forms. Do not use slang words. And try not to repeat the same word multiple times. Do not use the same words over and over again, which is the reason why I'm asking you to get minimum 10 to 15 different keywords from the audio. And to make it easier, we usually provide templates for our students. So if you need templates, don't worry, you can just contact us straight away. We can give you the templates as well. I'll give you a sample further too, so no need to worry. So use only academic keywords. Do not use any short forms. Do not repeat the same words over and over again. Do not use any slang words. Use only formal academic words. Now, what I have noticed is almost everyone easily gets the 6 points in the first three factors. Content, form, and vocabulary, it's not that hard to get, because with the template, it's really easy to get the 6 points out of 10. And many people lose points in grammar and spelling, and most of them because of careless spelling mistakes, careless grammar mistakes. When I say grammar mistakes, even minor errors, like if you do not start a sentence with a capital letter, if you start a new sentence with a small letter, that is a grammatical error. Each grammatical error will reduce 1 point. One mistake, 1 point will be deducted. If you have more than one mistake, all the 2 points for grammar will be deducted. That means even if you have 4 mistakes, 2 points for grammar will be deducted. So because altogether, grammar has only 2 points. That doesn't mean you should make more mistakes. Try to avoid grammatical mistakes completely at all cost, because you're supposed to get this 2 points for grammar only if there is no grammatical mistakes at all. So most common grammatical mistakes that I've seen among my students, starting a new sentence with a small letter, using a capital letter in the middle of your answer when it is not a proper noun. Do not use capital letters unnecessarily. Ending a sentence with a full stop. Make sure you always end a sentence with a full stop. If you do not use appropriate commas where it is necessary, that also will reduce your points for grammar. If you do not put space between two words, this is a very silly error that I see among many students. After writing a word, they write the next word immediately after without any space in between. You know, the problem with that is when the computer sees that word, it looks like a single word because there is no space in between. That also will reduce your spelling points because it looks like a wrong spelling word. So make sure you use or utilize all the 10 minutes given to you. Even if you finish typing early, utilize at least 1 to 2 minutes to double check mistakes like these. Grammatical mistakes regarding spacing, capitalizing, full stop, comma, spacing. Of course, grammatical sentence structure as well, like was instead of where, and instead of a, all these things will come under grammar. But those kind of mistakes we can easily correct using a template, which is the reason why it is always easier to use a template rather than framing your own answer, because you have only 10 minutes time. out of 10 minutes, around 1 to 2 minutes will be taken up by the audio. So if you're going to the exam center, you're under exam pressure, like everyone is taking the exam at the same time. So when you're under exam pressure, you hear a random audio, you're taking down notes. And if you try to frame your sentence structure at that time, that'll be too much work for you. That'll be too tiring for you. And you might end up with more spelling and grammar mistakes, which is the reason why it is best not to improvise your answer at that moment. Have a template memorized so you already are sure about what you're supposed to write. And when you go to the exam, you just need to pick out some keywords from the audio and use it in the template provided to you. Okay, so that's why it's very important to check your grammar, proofread, spelling, and grammar. Spelling also really important. If you make one spelling mistake, you lose 1 point. More than one spelling mistake, all the 2 points for spelling will be deducted. So spelling, one mistake that I told before, if you do not put space between two words, and even after a punctuation, you should put a space. Even after a comma, you should put a space. Don't put the space before the punctuation. Punctuation means comma, full stop, these things. These are called punctuations. So wherever you use a punctuation, punctuation should be immediately after the word. Space should be after the punctuation. Some people tend to put the space before the punctuation. Word, space, and punctuation, which is wrong. You should be writing word, punctuation, then space. Okay, put the correct spacing. Spelling, one thing that you can do, if you heard a word in the audio, but you're not so sure about the spelling of it, just don't write it in your answer. Because if you write and make a mistake, you will definitely lose points for your spelling. But if you don't write that point, it's okay. You can still write other keywords from the audio. Minimum 10 is enough and more here. All right. So avoid spelling mistakes at all cost. If you don't know the spelling, don't write it in your answer. Now, a few things to remember, like I already mentioned, note down at least 10 to 15 keywords from the lecture. And if you're a person who is weak in grammar, instead of taking down random keywords, try to take complete phrases from the audio. Not sentences, complete phrases would be sufficient. Phrases means the important part of an audio. For example, they are saying, today's lecture will be about pollution in the 20th century. So you should take down the part pollution in the 20th century. You don't have to write today's lecture will be about. You don't have to write the entire sentence. Just note down the meaningful part of the sentence in your notebook. And even that, don't try to write it in a complete grammar, complete spelling, because nobody is going to look at your notes. The notes is just for you to remember the point. So you use short forms when you write down your answer. I'll show you a sample further. And in your entire answer, use connectives as much as possible, like moreover, also, additionally, furthermore, hence, firstly, secondly. All these kind of words would be very helpful for your overall form, your structure. Because when you use the key connective words like however, moreover, furthermore, it shows that you know academic vocabulary. It shows that you have a good structure in your answer. It is really good for your written discourse scoring. So use connectives as much as possible, or use a template which has plenty of connectives in them, or use a template where you don't have to use so much of grammar. The template itself should cover most of your grammatical part. Okay, and yeah, so let's do a sample question now. So all of you can listen to the audio. So what I'll do along with you, I'll take down notes as well. Ready? Oops, I'm on my headphones. I'll just play it outside. Just a second.
The first example of what could be called a newspaper was the Acta Diurna, roughly daily news, that Julius Caesar introduced in 59 BC. This was a handwritten news sheet posted daily in the Forum at Rome and in other common meeting places around the city. Of course, a lot of the news would be out of date in the sense that, for example, it took a long time for reports of a victory in a distant country to get back to Rome. Nonetheless, a lot of the items included are similar to those found in more modern newspapers. News of battles, as already mentioned, as well as political and military appointments, political events, and even a social diary recording marriages, births, and deaths. One mustn't forget sport, if that is what you call it. Just like modern fans of football, sports-minded Romans could keep up with the latest results of the gladiator contests. People who lived in the provinces and wanted to be kept up to date would send scribes to Rome to copy the news and have them send it back by letter. Many of these scribes could make extra money by providing the news to more than one client. Quite a few of them were slaves, and would go on to use the extra money earned to buy their freedom.
Okay, so I forgot that I had already taken down notes previously for this. So I'll show you the sample of the notes that I took in the next page. So this is how you take down notes. See, I have not written the entire sentence. So the first point that I took is first example of newspapers. See, I did not write the entire word newspaper here. I only used NP, which is short form for newspaper. I'll understand that because I heard the audio, right? Which is the reason why I asked you, do not try to take down the entire word or the entire sentence. Take down short forms. Use short forms to write down your notes, which can save you a lot of your time. More importantly, if you try, like, let's say if I'm trying to write first example of newspaper, by the time they talk about Julius Caesar and 59 BC, I'll be still writing the first point. So I'm losing a lot of keywords from the audio. So what you do when you take down notes, do not try to write the complete sentence or the correct spelling of the word. Use short forms, which is easy for you to understand. So the first point that I wrote is first example of newspaper, then is time of Julius Caesar, then there is 59 BC. So if you notice, most of these are names. Julius Caesar, 59 BC is a time. Handwritten news sheets is a noun. Common meeting places of Rome. News of battles. See, news, I wrote only NWS. Political and military appointments. So I wrote only POLTCL. I still understand because it is political and military appointments. Social diary of marriage. I wrote it completely. You don't have to write like this. Use short forms wherever possible. Social diary of marriages, births and deaths, sports, scribes and slaves. So what do? Do not take your notes on the screen given to you. Take down notes on your notebook because you can write faster than typing. Take down notes on your notebook. Once the audio is over, you can look at your notes and type your answer. Now, based on the points which I mentioned before, incorrect grammar, incorrect spelling, incorrect word count, and incorrect vocabulary, as well as including minimum 10 to 15 keywords from the audio with a lot of connectives, I have written a sample answer. You can have a look. You can even come up with your own template after looking at the sample, or the students who have already joined us, we are already providing them with templates. So if you need them, just reach us on 0432-269-874. So this is the sample answer. So my total answer was around 66 words. The minimum word limit was 50, maximum was 70. I wrote somewhere in the middle, but 60 plus 66. And my answer is, first example of newspaper was the focus of the lecture. Firstly, the speaker mentioned handwritten news sheets published in 59 BC, introduced by Julius Caesar. Now, I have used the word firstly. So in all the coming sentences, if you notice, I have used secondly, thirdly, moreover, and lastly. These connective words will make the computer understand that I have around 3 to 4 points, all arranged in a proper manner, which looks like a really good structure. So use connectives as much as possible. Firstly, secondly is easy to remember. Firstly, secondly, thirdly, moreover, lastly is a good way to start every sentence except for the introduction part. And even if you have noticed here, in the first line, firstly, the speaker mentioned, I use the word mentioned. Secondly, I wrote elaborated. I did not repeat mentioned again, because if I repeat mentioned again, this won't be good for my vocabulary, which is the reason why I'm using different words like mentioned, elaborated. For thirdly, I have used highlighted. Moreover, I used talked about. Lastly, I used concluded. I'm using different words in different lines to boost my vocabulary. Because if you simply write, firstly, she talked about, secondly, she talked about, thirdly, she talked about, you repeat it the same. And it is a very simple keyword as well, vocabulary, very simple word as well, which won't give you much points for your vocabulary. So try to use different vocabulary like mentioned, elaborated, highlighted, emphasized, talked about, discussed, concluded, any of them should be fine, but do not repeat the same more than one time. Don't even repeat it once. Okay, do not repeat even one time. And in the first line that I wrote again, I have written, firstly, the speaker mentioned handwritten news sheets published in 59 BC, introduced by Julius Caesar. Even if you do not write the part introduced by Julius Caesar, it's perfectly fine because I will still have 63 words, even if I remove those 3 words. But I wrote it because Julius Caesar is an important keyword. But let's say when you go to the exam, you're confused about the spelling of Julius Caesar. What do? Just don't write that word, because only if you write and tend to make a mistake, then that will be counted as a spelling mistake. And then also if it is a wrong spelling, it won't be considered as a keyword either. So there is no point in writing it. So if you do not know the spelling, avoid using the word in your answer completely. Like if you don't know the spelling of Julius Caesar, do not use the word Julius Caesar in your answer at all. Even if you use it, if it is a wrong spelling, it won't be counted as a keyword. Okay,
Secondly, she elaborated on common meeting places of Rome. Thirdly, she highlighted news of battles, political and military appointments. Battles and political and military appointments. Moreover, she talked about social diary of marriages, births and deaths. Lastly, she concluded with a few words on slaves and scribes. So I have almost used all the keywords that I have noted down here. And if at all you're not, you also do the same thing. When you listen to the audio, do not stop when you feel that you have got enough keywords. You keep on writing until the end of the audio. Once the audio is over, while you type your answer, choose out the best ones and choose out the ones that you're sure of regarding the spelling. If you do not know the spelling, do not use it in your answer. Right. Okay. So this is pretty much regarding the task called summarize spoken text. This is the first task in listening, just summarizing everything that we said. This is a sample screenshot. You will have the instruction on top. You'll be typing the answer in the box at the bottom. Word count will be given at the bottom. You don't have to count it. Time remaining out of 10 minutes will be given on the top right of the corner, top right corner of the page. You have 10 minutes per question. There is no rollover time. So even if you finish early, do not move to the next question immediately. Utilize minimum 1 to 2 minutes in the last part for double checking your spelling and grammar before you move on. Make sure you double check spacing, capitalizing, comma, full stop, spelling of the words, sentence structure, all of it should be checked before you move on to the next question. You get 10 points per question. And when it is converted to 90, it is contributing around 13 points to listening and 12 points for writing. Include minimum 10 to 15 matching keywords. Write only within 50 to 70 words, nothing less, nothing more. Do not use any slang words or short forms. Slang words like gonna, none of them. Use only formal academic words. Do not repeat the same word over and over again. Do not make any grammatical mistakes. Do not make any spelling mistakes. If you do not know the spelling of something that they mentioned, do not use it in your answer. And in your answer, use connectives such as moreover, furthermore, firstly, secondly, thirdly, lastly, any of them, and use different words like mentioned, elaborated, discussed, highlighted, emphasized, concluded, any of them. All right. Okay, so that's pretty much it for summarized spoken text, guys. I hope this helps you a lot. So practice as many questions as possible. So just watching these videos won't be enough for your preparation. You should get the templates. You should get the guidance from an expert trainer. Get one-to-one feedback, because whatever you hear, you know, you might understand something, but unless you check it with the trainer, you will not know whether you're following the techniques correctly. So make sure you watch the videos, learn them, practice them, get the feedback from a trainer, improve on the points mentioned by the trainer, get back to the trainer again, get more feedback until you make sure that you're doing everything 100% correctly. Okay. All right, guys, I'll be back soon with other videos, other question types as well. So those who have not watched the other videos, please have a look too. It'll be really helpful for you. I have created videos on most of the important question types. I'll be continuing further. So see you soon.